Yeah, good.
I'm extremely sorry.
I'm sorry. You might be perplexed because of this in-depth
switch the screen off.
Of mine.
She wants, this is her presentation.
Okay.
Sorry. So I'll tell you, I'll break that down. Thing is, there are a few cells in my brain which are tweaked a bit different than yours. No worry, I'm not a crazy or such, but these cells get hyperactive or extravagantly unhappy when they see something which is not clean, or some dust is found at this point of view, or as simple as such, if a laptop is half open. These might look peanuts to you, but not for a person who's carrying these cells in the head. Process of carrying these cells is called OCD, which is obsessive compulsive disorder. For many of such, and including myself, this was a fancy term for not being clean and tidy. But it was my class teacher who was first amongst and identified and mentioned it to me, because I was very particular about placing my bag, lunchbox, the pencil box, you know how it is. I told my mother about this and she said, come on, beta, it is always good to make sure to keep things clean. Of course, mom, I am making extra sure to make things clean. But I convinced myself, it's fine that this extra wouldn't do any harm, but it already created a mess. How? Even till date, I make sure my floors in the house are reflecting the lights hanging on the wall. Yes, I do. My dining table is set correctly with its cutlery and always has a jar filled with water with a closed lid. Closed. My bed sheet is folded and has two pillows resting on the head side of the bed. Head side meaning where there is a lean over and you can lean. That's the head side. And the cups are arranged according to the sizes in the shelves. And I can add on to this list. Had there been any ripple created in the above mentioned list, my mind would go crazy. How? The next slide. This. And I would leave my dinner midway, even though it's serving the best pizza, to calm the ripple down. It's not easy. I'll give a small example to that. It was during my boards when I was having my exams on neck, and it was that time when notepads and fancy stationery was a trend. Plus, it was a gauge meter to decide upon how much effort you have put in the exam. So for some unknown reason, I used to use pencil and eraser. Now, for every time I erased something, the leftovers used to fall on my favorite quilt. With no need of coffee, my brain cells used to get activated. What do I search for? Wiping cloth, which has to be wet, so that I can take my quilts very neatly. I don't have a dustbin here, but my pocket will help. So I used to clean off all those leftovers. I can't throw it off on the floor, because that will turn my reflecting floor into a non-reflecting one. I can't throw it off a window or a balcony, because there is a probability for the air to push them back, land them on the floor. What is to be done? Carry them, take it in the trash, press much deep down so that they can't feel the air to fly back. Can you imagine? I have spent the last 45 seconds talking to you about the leftovers of an eraser. That heavy was this extra of my making sure things clean. My mom was asking, why was the light in the kitchen going on and off for every hour? Because mom, I had to save my quilt and the floor from making something bad happen to them. This is OCD, guys. But it took me 5 years to educate myself that this is one amongst the 10 most disabling illness. I'm not saying this, the World Health Organization sees it. Let's understand why did it even bang its first position in the 10 illness. This OCD was actually first written about by Sigmund Freud. He named it as psychosexual development. Okay, now chill everybody, it's nothing great, but there are seven categories of OCDs. Yes, defined by DSM, which is Diagnostic Statistical Manual for Mental Disorders. You heard it right, we have a manual for mental disorders. Yes. First is checking. You keep checking repetitive things like your phone, a window, the gas, which I don't have. I don't check that. Second, contamination, which is fair. You know, you're scared to face a public area which is not going to be clean. And reason why I ended up cleaning a wash basin area in an airport. I did it. Third is mental contamination. You use lot of sanitizers when you meet somebody new. This is the best one, I'm telling you. The Lifebuoy is also good, but that's very mentioned. Okay, keeping that aside, sorry. The fourth one is rumination. You keep thinking about one single question, if that is away from your belief. Why did that person say when it was blue, was when it was actually dark blue. You spend hours. The fifth one is intrusive thoughts. You spend on one single question. Are you valid enough for this job? Are you enough a good person? Why are you existing on this earth? I don't do this. I'm a princess in my world. Okay. The next one is hoarding. You are disability to warn off your possessions. Meaning, suppose this top which I'm wearing is actually from my inter 10th. So I can't throw this off because I just can't. It's very difficult. That's hoarding. The last one is actually symmetry and patterns. You must have seen. And the most disturbing thing right now here is this Jenga, which is, you know, I can't tell you how difficult it is to look at this and talk to you guys. So yes, that is symmetry and patterns because, yeah, I can't explain you in detail because I go crazy. Adding some statistics to it, 4% of Indian population are suffering with OCD. I'm not stating this again. It's by the National Central Biology Center in India, which have come up with the statistics. Imagine 4%, meaning every 1 in 25 are actually facing with this OCD. Strange. Okay, enough statistics. Now what does this do? It can drag a person into depression because that person is scared that he's not actually having that image of cleanliness in his mind. The person will not try something new because he's scared those cells will get activated for no reason. The fear doesn't end there. The person can also become an alcohol addict. I'm not an alcohol addict, but I'm additive. I'm not a brand ambassador for this, but I still love them. See, they're so handy. Okay, I'm sorry. Okay. The next thing is, adding two more statistics to it is, a person will not be happy even when he knows that things are fine this way. He doesn't. Imagine it was during my 2016 New Year, I was running to search for a sanitizer because the cake left its stains on my hand. I missed out the countdown. What to do? I know it's crazy. So that's how OCD is. For all those, please agree if it is faced by you, because I did. Okay? Thank you. Sanitize if anybody you can have for me.